And I miss you. You look beyond me. You have shown me mercy, mercy. You have shown me mercy. You look beyond you. Out of water, you have shown me mercy. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. You're welcome, sir. Big brother, you're welcome. You're welcome. I think you are welcome. You have showed me mercy. You have shown me mercy. You have showed me mercy. You have shown me mercy. You look beyond you. Oh, Adam, you have shown me mercy. Welcome, Auntie Sandra. Welcome. We are going on prayers this morning. It's going to be more or less prayers. Good morning, sir. Reverend Pippi, good morning, sir. You have shown me mercy. Mali Brahim de la Boshanania. Zali Brahim Scotoli Branda Boshanania. Zananania de Branda Boshanania. Let's appreciate God this morning. Let's appreciate God. Tell him you are worthy. You are greater than the greatest. Wonderful Jehovah, Exchange of Days, Immortal Redeemer, I am that I am, the King of Glory, Mighty Redeemer. Good morning, Auntie Chaka. Good morning, Brother Fanny. Let's appreciate him. Let's give him thanks. Mali bra in the bow, Shanania. Escoto libra in the bow, Shanana libra in the bow, Shia. Zanananania Escoto libra in the bow, Shia. You're welcome. You're welcome, my wife, beautiful wife. You're welcome. If you give to Zana Nanania in the bush, Shanania Zana Nanania Escoto Libra in the bush, Shanania Malibra in the bush, Escoto Libra in the bush. Let's appreciate God this morning. Tell him thank you. Tell him you are worthy, you are righteous, you are faithful. I'm the one you showed mercy. That is what the song is talking about. You will confirm it now that God have showed mercy. There is a mercy in the house. There is a mercy in all around. Ma libra escoto libra in the bush. You look beyond me. Yes, sir. You have showed me mercy. Thank you, Jesus, for keeping me alive. Thank you for the gift of life. Za libra escoto libra in the bush. Za na 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 in the bush. Thank you, Jesus. Ma libra escoto. You are worthy. He's righteous. He is righteous. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Libra in the bush. Father, thank you for this morning. Thank you, Immortal Redeemer. Thank you. You're welcome, sir. You are welcome. You are welcome. A good in-law. You are welcome. Mr. Duffy, you are welcome, sir. Manananania in the bush. Anania is koto libra in the bush. Zananana in the bush. Anananania. In the bush. Anananania. Zananania libra. In the bush, Father, you are a faithful God. Yes, sir. Ma libra escoto libra in the bush. Zananania in the bush. Good morning, sir. Zalibra in the bush. Good morning, my dear Chiamaka. Good morning. Zalibra escoto libra in the bush. Le candele bush, nana in the bush. You are worthy to be praised. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Appreciate him. I'm coming with prayers after my midnight prayers. I started my midnight prayers tonight around 1:30 and I closed down midnight prayers around 6:30 this morning. That is the place God took me in the morning when I was closing my prayers. That is exactly where I want to pray with you. What I want, yeah, I want to pray with you from that place because it's a beautiful and a powerful place. So I think this morning is going to be prayers. It's going to be blessings of God. This morning is going to be God's upon God's favor. It's going to be God's favor upon your life, upon my life, because I heard him clearly this morning. Because I prayed this morning for 6 good hours and he told me something. He told me something. What he told me is what we are about to share. Ma libra escoto libra in the bush. Father, we thank you. Father, we worship you. Thank you for making it possible for us to be alive at the land of living. Come and have your way. Come and tell full supremacy this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Let's open our week. This week will favor you. Divine open doors will locate you. Divine testimony shall be your portion. Whatever you lay your hands will prosper. Divine grace will go with you. In business, you will succeed. In the office, I declare divine favor. Wherever you lay your hands, you will prosper. Divine open doors in your business. Divine good health, marital settlement, good cars, good houses. That your praying life that have been having issues, receive grace to pray more, grace to fast more, grace to go higher. Every family battles, this week Jehovah will end your family battles. This week Jehovah will end your family challenges. This week Jehovah will end your financial challenges. This week Jehovah will end your health challenges. Whatever you have been struggling with this week, Jehovah will end it. I see God healing somebody in the knee right now. If you're having a knee issue, be healed right now. I saw a hand, they're rubbing a knee. Come on. Receive your healing in your knees right now. In the name of Jesus. Whatever that have been your challenge, this week is a week of healing. Prepare your mind for divine healing, because I heard him clearly this morning when I closed my midnight prayers. I started around 1:30 and I closed around 6:32. When I checked the time, and God said to me, Jeremiah 33, this is a time when God is about to do something new. So just stay. If you are too busy, I know some is in the office, some are watching from their office, some are watching from the road where they are walking. But wherever you stop, try to finish watching it in the next few minutes, because it's just prayers. I'm not going to take much of your time. So permit me right away to be reading from the Bible while I pray with you. Look at what Jeremiah chapter 33. Let me start from verse 2. Thus says the Lord, who made it? The Lord who formed it to establish it. The Lord is his name. Thus says the Lord. Now look at what the Lord said in verse 3. Call me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Call me, I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things which you do not know. I pray with you, only mentioning the name Jesus, only typing the name Jesus. That is a mystery you are going to see. If you want to type your type, if you want to write your, if you want to type your type, if you want to shout it wherever you are, you can shout it wherever you are. Type the name Jesus, type the name Father, type the name Jesus. Bible say, call me and I will answer you, and I will reveal mighty things. When Bible say call me, that simply means pray out your needs. That simply means open your mouth and pray. But I think I prayed in your behalf tonight, because my prayers last night was not really for myself, but I pray for all my well-wishers, all the members, all my fans, all the siblings, all the brothers and sisters, all the members from far and near, within the country and outside the country. That was my major prayer point. I just took last night to pray for people. I didn't really have any major prayer point for my personal needs. So I prayed for you last night. So I think with the prayers I have prayed for you, you typing Jesus, you shouting Jesus, can walk with the prayers together, because the Bible says one which is 1,000, two which is 10,000. So I clip my midnight prayers with the word Jesus this morning. I clip my midnight prayers with the word Father. I clip my midnight prayers with the word Jehovah. Let mighty things be revealed about your life. Let mysteries be revealed about your life. I declare, Bible says, I will show you mighty things. May Jehovah show you mighty wealth. May he show you mighty favor. May he show you mighty open doors. May he show you mighty grace. May he show you mighty wealth. May he show you mighty favor. Everything about you, I declare mightiness of God in the name of Jesus. I don't know what you have been asking God. How do I go about this? There is a solution to that question you are asking. I don't know the prayer point you have been struggling. How do I start? There is a solution to it. So I pray with you. As you shout the name Jesus, come and receive your marital settlement. As you shout the name Jesus, come and receive your business breakthrough. As you shout the name Jesus, come and receive your new job, receive your new promotion. As you shout the name Jesus, receive your healing right away in the name of Jesus. As you shout the name Jesus, receive your open doors in the name of Jesus. As you shout the name Jesus, come and receive your favor. You are favored right now. I decree. Bible say, call my name and I will reveal and I will show you mighty things and greater things. Call my name and I will show you mighty healings. Call my name and I will show you mighty open doors. Call my name and I will give you mighty connections. Call my name and I will give you mighty favor. Call my name and I will give you mighty grace. Call my name and I will give you mighty promotion. Call my name and I will give you mighty connections. Call my name and I will give you total deliverance. Call my name, I will give you open doors. Call my name, I will give you total healing. Call my name, I will give you child. Call my name, I will give you marital settlement. Call my name, I will give you visa. Call my name, I will give you a job. Call my name, I will open your file. Call my name. That is what God said. Mention of his name, that mighty things shall be revealed, that greater things shall be revealed. Receive a greater things. Na libra in the bosha nani. Escoto libra in the bosha. Li papa in the bosha. I stand upon my midnight prayers. in your behalf. I decree whatever you have been asking God, whatever you have been thinking about it personally, whatever you have been asking God personally, and you have been asking God, where do I start? How do I go about it? And there is a solution in the house. There is a healing in your new camp. There is a healing in your waist. There is a healing in your chest. There is a healing in your ear. There is a healing in your system. No more sugar. No more diabetes. No more hepatitis. No more HIV. No more kidney problem. No more chest pain. No more cholesterol sickness. No more high BP, no more cataracts, no more glaucoma, no more barrenness, no more fibroid, no more crimpedness, no more deafness, no more blindness, no more poverty, no more setback, no more challenges of the enemies, no more enchantments, no more invokements, no more setback. That is a grace that is speaking for you. May that grace speak for you permanently in the name of Jesus. There is no more asthma, no more tuberculosis, no more. Call my name and I will settle all those things. Call my name and I will give you breakthrough. Call my name and I will give you money. Call my name and I will give you houses. Call my name and I will give you cars. Call my name and I will make all things possible. He said, I will show you mighty things. When God is talking about mighty things, he's talking about both physically, financially, politically, academically, even spiritually. God is talking about the boat. So receive greater grace for your new level. In the name of Jesus, let's quickly move ahead. Now look at what verse 4 says. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the house of the city and the houses of the king of Judah, which I have pulled down to fortify against the siege monks and the sword. Then verse 5, they came to fight with the Canaanites, but only to fell their place with a dead bodies of men who I slayed in my anger and my fury, all for whose wickedness I have hidden my face. This place is talking about, you know, the people of Israel, whom that when God was angry with them, God permitted them to have issues. When God was angry with them, there was much dead bodies. When God is angry with them, there was much sicknesses. But look at what verse 6 says. Bible said that they went to fight before they could come back. There are many dead bodies. There are many dead bodies, that their houses were pulled down, that everything they have was destroyed. I don't know a man who leave his own in order to come to your zone to fight you. I don't know that person who leave his house in order to come to your house to fight you. I don't know who leave his problem in order to go to native doctor only to fight you. Hear me and hear me clear. Before they will go to that native doctor and come back, what Jehovah did here is what will happen in their family. Whatsoever they plan to do, they plan to kill you, their dead body will be found in their own houses. If they plan to pull you down, their downfall will be found in their own houses. Bible said, and God kept quiet over Israelites because they went astray, because they went to fight a war that they didn't ask God for the permission for. God was angry and God permitted people to conquer them. You know, what am I trying to say? There are people, they don't think about their life. They don't think about their family. They don't talk about their situations. So, the things they think about is how to kill another, is how to fail another, is how to fight another. Hear me, I pray with you this morning, any man or woman who always leave his house in the night in the name of witchcraft, who always leave their house in the daytime, or any man that leave their house in the daytime to go to native doctor against you, hear me clear. Before their arrival, their family will pay the price. Before their arrival, they will pay the price by themselves. Whatever they did can never be your portion. I don't know who have been charging you all this while. Jehovah is about to do something new. Look at what verse 6 says. Behold, I will bring it health and healing, and I will heal them, and I will reveal to them the abundance of peace and truth. I don't know a man who is fighting you based on your error, who is fighting you based on your past mistake. I don't know who is judging you because of your past mistake. I don't know who is judging you because of your failure. I don't know who is judging you because of the weak point of your father or your mother. Anybody using your past against you, Jehovah said that I should let you know that from now you will no longer be called a failure. From now you will no longer be called a sick person. I don't know who is waiting for your death. I don't know who is waiting for your failure. I don't know who is waiting for sickness to cut hold of you. I don't know who is waiting for you to die in that sickness. I don't know who is waiting for you to die based on the manipulation they did. Jehovah said that I should let you know that failure is no longer your portion. That setback is no longer your portion. That manipulations is no longer your portion. That enchantments is no longer your portion. That manipulations is no longer your portion. God said that I should let you know this morning, from any angle you are having challenges of life, Jehovah have come to settle it. Any weapon that be using against you, any mistake of your life that be using against you, the same God that showed the Israelites mercy have come to show you and I mercy. Come and receive a correction of that mistake. Receive a testimony in the same place you fell. Receive your rise right now in the name of Jesus. Who is fighting you with your mistake? I don't know who you confided on. I don't know who you led. I don't know who you confided on. I don't know who you told about yourself, and they are now using it against you. I don't know who heard about your story, and they are using it against you. I don't know who heard about your financial crisis, your ministerial crisis, your office crisis, your health crisis, and they are using it against you one way or the other. Jehovah said, I will heal that sickness they are using against you. I will heal that manipulations they are using against you. God said, I will correct that mistake about your life they are using against you. God said that I should let you not cry not. God said, weep not. All the hands that have fought you all this while, Jehovah said, I will fight them back. I have come to restore. Bible said, I will bring good health. I will bring healing. I don't know if you are sick in any angle. Sick in your ministry. Come and receive a ministerial healing. If you are sick in health, receive your healing right now. Those sickness, BP, high BP, fever, cold, any kind of, you know, any kind of sickness, any kind of problem, any manipulation of any angle, God said, I will bring healing upon the land. Come and receive your healing right now. Your healing is in the house. Those that mock you before will come back to celebrate with you. Those that laugh at you before will come back to celebrate with you. There is a healing in the house. God said, I will heal you. He said, before I rejected you, but now I have accepted you. Before I abandoned you, but now I have accepted you. I kept quiet over you because of a little mistake, but now I have come to correct your mistake. Manana is kotolebra. Who is laughing at you? Who is mocking you? I pity that person. Your miracle is sure right now. Your testimony is assured right now. Manana is kotolebra in the labosha. Libra in the yakalebra. Eskoto manana libra in the labosha. Your testimony is assured. Your miracle is granted. What they think is no longer what it is. God have changed your story. Your dancing step have changed. Your business step have changed. Everything about you have changed. Your health have changed. A dancing step, they made it for bad, but God have turned it for good. They are using your weak point against you, your little mistake against you, but there is an abundant grace that is speaking for you. I don't know the angle you have been calling God. Which angle have you been calling God? God correct this error. God amend this situation. There is an amendment in the house last night. There is an amendment at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is an adjustment at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is a correction at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is a grace that is speaking for you. Congratulations. You are no longer what men think that you are. You are no longer in the level where men think that you are. There is a solution in the house. There is a testimony in the house. Your story has changed for good. He said, I will bring good health. He said, I abandoned them before, but now I have restored them. Come and receive your restoration in your relationship. I don't know how you lose your relationship. I don't know how you lose your marriage. I don't know how you lose your job. I don't know how you lose your business strategies. I don't know how you lose your ministerial strategy. I don't know how you lose the grace. I don't know how you lose the vision. I don't know how you lose the gift of grace. I don't know how you lose your vision. I don't know how you lose your prophetic grace. God is bringing a restoration in the house this morning. I don't know how you lost your health. Come and receive your total favor. I don't know how you, one challenge or the other made you to be disfocused in your destiny. It looks as if you are no longer in the track. It looks as if you are no longer in the track of your academics. It looks as if you are no longer in the track, so in the track of that dream, of that vision you used to see. But there is a restoration in the house. Manana eskoto libra in the labosha. There is a meeting at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is a readjustment at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is an adjustment at the Sanctum Sanctorum. There is a correction at the Sanctum. A banner was lifted up. A band was lifted up. A boundary was leveled for your sake, because God wants to connect you again. Every spiritual boundary, physical boundary, every connection that be hindering you from the rightful connections was dissolved last night. I know that is it. There is a correction. There is an adjustment. There is a readjustment. There is a correction in the house. There is a grace that spoke last night. My dear, something new is about to happen. Something great is about to happen. He said, call my name and I will show you great and mighty things. There are great and mighty things in your behalf. There are greater testimonies on your way. Those that mock you, I pity them. Those that flatter you, I pity them. Those that you use your weak point against you, I pity them. Because there is serious adjustment. There is serious readjustment. There is serious amendment. There is a serious correction. There is a serious, in fact, a boundary between you and your destiny and your connection and your favor and God was leveled last night. So your miracle is assured. Congratulations. Back to your spiritual life, back to your gift, back to your vision, back to your trust, back to your dream life, back to your destiny, back to your academic life, back to your profession, back to your business, back to that you have been asking God. Congratulations. It is settled in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. And I will cause the captive of Judah and the captive of Israel to return, and I will rebuild those places as at the first. I will rebuild. I will cause the captive to come back. Who is keeping your destiny captive? Who kept your miracle in captive? Who kept your health in captive? Who kept your testimony in captive? Who kept your connection and captive. This is where the message lies. Zanana Elia, Elia, Elia. Manana Eskotolibra in the Bosha. Whatever that belongs to you that have been in captive for this world, Jehovah is restoring it right now. Come on, get rid, get rid, get rid. There is a restoration in the house. There is a rebuilding in the house. Manana Eskotolibra in the Bosha. Li Papa Sundayaka, Manana Eskoto. Li Papa in the Bosha, Nana Libra Eskoto. Sananania in the Bosha, Nanania. Li Papa Eskotolibra in the Bosha. There is a rebuilding in the house. There is a renovation in the spiritual realm. God is renovating something. God is renovating your spiritual life. God is renovating your destiny. I don't know where it will be pulled off from, where it will be kicked out of balance. Jehovah is restoring. Jehovah is rebuilding. Manana is, where are you expecting him? In which angle do you need him? There is a rebuilding in the house. There is a readjustment in the house. He said, I will rebuild. He said, I will bring back those Judas and Israelis that is in captive. That simply means, I will bring back that marriage that is in the hand of your enemies. I will bring back that business that is in the hand of the enemies. That simply means, I will bring back your ministerial grace that is in the hand of the enemies. I will bring back your womb that is in the hand of the enemies. Your unborn children that is in the hand of the enemies. That your connection, that importation grace that you are meant to have, that connection, that contact, that contrast you are meant to have, that good health, that marriage, that visa, that connection, that expansion, that extension, that enlargement that you needed to have, that's your code that needed to be enlarged. I don't know who have been keeping it in captive. God said that I should let you know this morning. He said, I will bring them back to you. Come on, let's pray right away based on that place. I decree, let your good health be restored. Let your miracles be restored. Let your favor be restored. Let your wealth be restored. Let your spiritual life be restored. Let your ministerial life be restored. Let your academic life be restored. He said, I will bring back. I will bring back. I will restore. Manana in the bosha. Le candrebosha nana eskoto libra. Indaya kakalebra eskoto libra in the bosha. When there is a readjustment and the Santo Santo doors open, favor speaks, open door comes, favor comes, doors open. God gives you connection, gift to start to come. Spiritual life will be connected again. Financial life will be connected again. Everything, business life will be connected again. Political grace will return back again. Bible said, I will restore Israel and Judah. That simply means, I will restore parents and children. I will restore Israel and Judah. That simply means, I will restore father, mother, and their children. I will restore parents and their children. That simply means, I will no longer allow that man to die premature. I will no longer allow that woman to die premature. I will allow them to live and eat the fruit of their labors. That simply means, I will no longer allow that child to be useless. I will make that child to be useful. He said, I will restore Judah and Israel. That simply means I will make the parents healthy and I will make their children fruitful. I will make the parents healthy and I will make their children fruitful. Malibra Eskoto. Indelebushanana. Congratulations. There is a healthiness in the house. There is a favor in the house. There is an opening in the house. There is a promotion in the house. There is a connection in the house. There is a favor in the house. Whatever you will be struggling to have, congratulations. It's granted, it's assured. It's granted, it's assured. In the name of Jesus. I can't wait. I can't wait. I can't wait. And I will cleanse them from all their iniquities by which they have sinned against me. And I will ponder all the iniquities by which they have sinned and by which they have transgressed against me. God said, I will wipe away iniquities. Zanana indelebo shanania. I don't know that person that your mind keeps, you know, your mind keep being against you. Your mind keep being condemning you. Come on. Come on. You better tell your mind I'm free. Tell yourself I'm free. Tell the challenges I'm free. Tell that sin I'm delivered. Tell that sin I'm forgiven. All which I'm forgiven. Any sin pointing at me, any past mistake pointing at all which I'm forgiven. You are forgiven. All which pressure joy can, you are forgiven. Grace is speaking for you. Manana eskoto. Iana chosike all which precious. You are forgiven. God said, I will forgive your sickness. I will forgive your sins. I will forgive your past. Which past is speaking against you? I don't know the mind that is accusing you. I don't know the mistake you made, an abortion you made, the mistake you made, you lose an opportunity of grace, and your mind keeps telling you you have lost grace forever. Come and tell your mind that has not lost. Tell yourself there is a second chance. Tell yourself there is a second chance. There is a second chance. Don't let your mind accuse you. God said, I will forgive your iniquities, your trespasses, your past. I will forgive them. And I will adjust your life again. Who is your mind to condemn you? Who is the enemy to condemn you? Who is your great grandfather to condemn you? Who is the ghost of your father to condemn you? Who is the ghost of your mother to condemn you? Who is the ghost of your father's house to condemn you? Who is that member, that neighbor to condemn you? Who is that person? Who is that your wife, your husband to condemn you with a past mistake? When Jehovah said, I have forgiven. Did that mistake cause you any sickness? Receive your healing. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Did that mistake cause you to lose your promotion? Come on, God is bouncing you back. In the name of Jesus. Did the mistake cause you financial crisis? Come on, Jehovah is bouncing you back right away. In the name of Jesus. Did that mistake cause you your marriage, your relationship? Come on, Jehovah is restoring you to a better one, to a good one, to a powerful one. There is a restoration in the house. God is right, just things about you. He said, I will show you mercy. Who is my conscience to condemn me? When God has forgiven me, any devil, any tormenting spirit, any threat using my conscience against me, using your conscience against you, Jehovah is ratifying your case. My conscience, hear ye the word of the Lord. My sins have been forgiven. My conscience, hear ye the word of the Lord. My iniquities have been wiped away. My conscience, hear ye the word of the Lord. My mistakes have been readjusted. My conscience, hear ye the word of the Lord. My past have been condemned by God, have been rode away by God, have been passed by God, have been broke by God, but have been readjusted by God. Who is you? Who are you to condemn me? When grace speaks, who are you to condemn me? When favor speaks, who are you to condemn me? When miracle speaks, who are you to condemn me? When grace is available, who are you to condemn me? When mercy is available, who are you to condemn me? When favor is available, you can't condemn me when grace is speaking. You can't condemn me when mercy is speaking. You can't condemn me when favor has spoken. Who is you to condemn me when mercy said no to your condemnation? Who are you to condemn me when grace said no to your condemnation? Who are you to condemn me when favor said it's all over? Ma libra eskoto libra in the bosha. Li baba in the bosha. He said, I will restore. I will build. I will build. I will restore. Look at verse 9. That is the last of it. Then it shall be to me a name of joy, a praise, and a honor before all nations of the earth, who shall hear all the goodness that I do to them. They shall fall and tremble for the goodness and all the prosperity that I have provided for thee. God said, I kept quiet, but now I have come to restore. He said, hear ye the word of the Lord. By the time I will rebuild you, by the time I will bounce you back in health, by the time I will bounce you back in wealth, by the time I will bounce you back in open door, by the time I will bounce you back in riches, in connection, in importation, in political grace, in financial grace, ministerial grace, in business favor, academical grace, he said, by the time I will restore you, the earth will tremble. You shall be called a home of peace. You shall be called a home of joy. That simply means I will make you my residential address on earth. Jehovah said that I should let you know that he will make your house, your life, your business, your job, your good health, his residential address on earth. We are men who look for God, they will come to your house and see it. Where they will look for miracle, they will come to your house to see it. I want you to understand this place very well. God said, I will make you a home of peace. I will make you a home of joy. That simply means you have peace and joy all the days of your life. You will celebrate all the days of your life. There shall no longer be failure, crisis, and setback. I want you to understand this place. He said, I will make your life a residential address on earth. We are people who look for God. They will come to your family to see testimony. They will come to your ministry to see testimony. They will come to your church to receive testimony. They will ask you, how come? You will tell them it's God. He said, that will rebuild it. That the same mouth that laughed at you will come back to tremble. The same people that said no will come back and tremble. People who said you have failed will come back to see you arising. Only you are rising again. I don't know about you. Zalebra in the bush. You can type it if you feel like I'm rising again. You can type it, I'm bouncing back. These two words is important right now. You can shout it, you can type it. I'm bouncing back, I'm rising. I'm bouncing back, I'm bouncing back, I'm rising, I'm bouncing back. You can type it once, you can type it twice, you can type it 3 times, you can type it 10 times, you can type it 20 times. God said, I will bounce you back in good health. I will bounce those who see you as a sick person or not back. God said, I will bounce you back in health. They will see you, they will see you, they will see you that you are healed, they will see you that you are rising. People who said that your church no longer grow, people who said that my ministry no longer grow, God said, I will bounce mountain of change back again. They will come back to see the mountain of change have started rising, have started expatiating, have started growing, have started bouncing back, have started rising, have started enlarging. Manana eskoto lebra in the bush. God said, your enemies will confirm your greatness. Even your friends will confirm your greatness. People around you will confirm your greatness. They will confirm your marriage. Bible says, I will bounce you back in a good relationship. I will bounce you back in good business. Come on, get ready, get ready, get ready. Go, you better, if your account number is dormant, if your account is dormant, you better go and reactivate it. There is a connection coming on your way. You need that account to put that money. You need to make use of that account. Go. Reactivate it. I don't know what the struggle you have been having. Go and reactivate. Go and dust the seat of your church. Members are coming back. Dust your life. You know, I dust my chest. I dust my hands. I don't about you. I dust my palm for greatness. I dust my heart for greatness, for enlargement, for wealth. In fact, I dust my body for greatness, for God's blessing. I dust my father's house for greater blessing, for greater open doors, for greater breakthrough. In fact, in the spiritual land, let the house of my father be sweet. Let my house be sweet. I dust the life of my children. We wait for greatness. We wait for greater purpose. We wait for miracles. We wait for testimony. We wait for promotion. I wait for connection. He said, I will rebuild. I will make you rich and greater. I will give you healing. The people that call you a sick person will come to call you a healer. come to call you a huge person. The same people that mock you, that flatter you, that mock at you, that laugh at you, will come back to see greatness of God in you. I will restore you. I will build you. I will bounce you back. I will heal you. I will lift you. They will come back to see that you are alive. That what they think is no longer what it is. That what they talk is thought is no longer what it is. Manana eskoto libra in the bosha. Libra eskoto libra in the bosha. Zanana eskoto libra in the bosha. Libaba in the bosha. Libra eskoto libra in the bosha. I will bounce you back. And enemies will confirm. Friends will confirm. Colleagues will confirm. People around you will confirm. The world will hear your voice. In fact, I dust my eyes. I'm not dying yet. I will live to see it. I dust my eyes. I will live to see it. I dust my lips. My mouth will confess the greatness of God. I will soon see it, I believe. Receive that grace upon you. Receive that favor upon you. Congratulations. When God said yes, nobody can say no. I pray with you. Any angle you have been expecting, God, receive your blessings. Receive your breakthrough in your healing area. Receive your healing. Do you have any sick person around you that is a healing in the house? God said, I will visit with healing. I will visit with prosperity. I will visit with favor. I will visit with good job. Are you? Is there anyone around you that is looking for a better job? Come on, that job is here, right there, right now. Is there anyone around you that is looking for healing, divine breakthrough, divine open doors? Manana eskoto libra, divine favor, fruit of the womb, marital settlement, political favor. God said, I have made all available. Congratulations, for greatness is available. Greatness is available. Miracles is available. Testimonies is available. Congratulations. Congratulations. You are blessed above measure. You are lifted above measure. I pray with you. Beginning from today, whatever you seek, you will receive. Remember what Jeremiah 33:3 said. He said, call my name and I will show you mighty things and greater things. I will give you greater miracles, greater testimony, greater dreams and greater vision. I will give you greatness and I will make you great where men did not expect. Congratulations is your season. I pray with you this morning. Goodness shall follow you. Favor shall follow you. Open doors shall be your portion. I pray with you this morning, whatever you lay your hands will prosper. Whatever you set your eyes, God will favor you with it. Wherever you step your feet, you shall be favored. Greater grace shall go with you. Your week is blessed. Your Monday is blessed. Your Tuesday is blessed. Your Wednesday is blessed. Your Thursday is blessed. Your Friday is blessed. Your Saturday is blessed. Your Sunday is blessed. And your next week Monday is blessed as well. I can't wait to see you next week Monday. God bless you. God bless you. It is settled. It is settled. Wherever you are, lay your right hand on your chest or your left hand. Anyone, lay your hand on your chest. Father, let their heart desires be granted. Let their heart desires be perfected. Let the prayers they pray in their hearts be answered. Let their heart desire be granted. As you lay your hand on your heart, as you lay your hand on your chest, I pray with you, your prayers shall be answered. Your needs shall be greater, shall be granted. Your miracle shall be granted. Your favor shall be granted. That thing you thought in your heart, you think of it, you don't know who to confide on. You are tired of complaining to people. With that hand in your chest, with that hand in your heart, I call him mind reader. May he read your mind. May he give you testimonies. Congratulations. As that hand is there, your miracle is assured. Congratulations. Receive a relaxed mind. Receive peace. Receive joy. In Jesus' name I pray with you. Amen and amen. I remain your sister, Reverend Oluchi Precious Kamu. In case you are watching from YouTube or you're watching from Mountain of Change World, you want to join us every Monday morning by 7:30, you can log in with the name Evangelist Oluchi Precious Kamu. Thank you. Meet you again by this time on Monday. Listen to this message. I want you to understand it so that you know that the message is telling you the right footing. I'm the one you showed mercy. I'm the one. You have showed me mercy. You have showed me mercy. You look beyond me, oh. And I want. You have showed me mercy, mercy. You have showed me mercy, mercy. You look beyond me, oh. I'm the one, you have showed me mercy, you have showed me mercy, you look beyond me, oh. Exactly, he looked beyond us and he showed us this mercy this morning. For him to say, speak, I will answer. He said, call, I will showcase. He said, wait, I will rebuild and I will manifest. He said, wait, I will restore, that the world will hear your voice. Congratulations. Meet you again on Monday. You are blessed. I love you. I love you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' name we pray together this morning. Amen and amen.